Good morning.
Hey, big guy.
This is what Coachella is like in your 30s with chronic illness. Taping your knees before you go. And honestly, it fucking works.
Okay, day one recap. Honestly, day one of weekend one was kind of shitty and really lackluster for us. We weren't as excited about the day one lineup. And since we knew that we were gonna be going to weekend two, we skipped some acts that we really wanted to see for the first weekend. And we got in, we just kind of got situated. We went to see our friend who was bartending at Sunny's, which is Attaboy's pop-up. But we just had a good time like getting drinks. Then we caught a little bit of Gorillaz. And then we waited to see Maceo Plex, who we were all really excited for. We love Maceo Plex's Berlin Boiler Room set on YouTube. If you haven't seen it, oh, it's great. He really takes you on a journey. And that is not what happened when we saw him in Yuma. It was just like very generic sounding. And every single show that we saw at Yuma sounded almost exactly the same. So that was weekend one for us, kind of a letdown of a Friday. But weekend two, we had so much fun. We kicked it off early in the day with Muna, and it was so hot that day. Everybody was fucking dying. And let me just say, weekend two was way hotter apparently than weekend two of last year. Weekend two this year was just oppressively hot, and so it made seeing earlier acts a lot more difficult, especially for me because I have chronic illness. I had to make sure that if I was going in, I had my fan, I was taking a lot of my electrolytes and like drinking so much water. But still, we had a fucking blast, and Muna absolutely killed it. Obviously, when they sang Silk Chiffon to close out the set and they brought out all of Boy Genius, it was such a special moment for us because we're huge Boy Genius fans. It was great to see Phoebe singing with Katie and all of them on stage singing together. And actually on Friday night, we danced next to Julian Baker and her friend at Despacito, which is James Murphy and Too Many DJs collab. It's this beautiful, dark kind of disco hall, and they're spinning vinyl records, and it's just an incredible experience. And for us to be dancing next to Julian Baker the night before her performance was so special. And I was too chicken shit to say anything to her and say hi and tell her that I'm a big fan. I think now we are like huge Julian Baker fans. Saturday recap, we're gonna combine weekend one and two into each day recap just to make it a little bit shorter. We started with Ethel Kane, which was an incredible show. What's really cool about Ethel Kane is she grew up in a Southern Baptist home, I think in rural Florida, and her whole experience is about being raised in this deeply religious community. But then coming out as a trans woman and her whole experience feeling, you know, really pushed out of that community and her sort of internal struggle with that and coming into her own identity.
Beautiful set. It was one of the most powerful sets I've ever seen at Coachella. It was clearly a moment for her that probably like made one of the defining points of her career.
And then after that, we went to see Elderbrook at Sahara. John met up with some of our friends for Elderbrook, which was great, while I sat in the ADA section because I was just feeling like I could have heat exhaustion if I stand for too long. Weekend one, at that same time, we saw Charlie XCX, who's our girl. We saw her crash tour like 4 times, which is crazy. We love it so much. And undoubtedly, Charlie XCX gave like the performance of her career. And she really, really gave it all, especially during track 10. We'll be right back. it was amazing to see like a star is born, basically.
It could have been a really tough set because it was 5 o'clock and the sun was just beating down. There's no shade at all. Oh. And sometimes like a performer will go and have an amazing set, but the heat just takes it out of the crowd. And like they don't have anything left to give. Wasn't the case here. She gave it her all and everybody saw it.
Weekend one, we went to the kind of beer garden area next to Sahara. Then when we were leaving the beer garden, we walked by Gobi and we stumbled across Yeji, who we thought was sick when we were doing the research for Coachella, and she totally blew us away. So last night we got to see a little bit of Rosalía. I mean, after that, we've got to see her full show, I think, at a concert that is fully dedicated to her. She's such a goddamn star. Best performance of all of Coachella, by far, was Boy Genius. So good, in fact, that we went twice, weekend one and weekend two, and I have the post-Boy Genius depression today, where you get that feeling after experiencing something so euphoric and incredible that I'm almost sad because I'm worried I'll never experience that again.
Yeah, so this was another record that I had heard multiple times before coming to. And I had no idea what I was walking into weekend one to go there. And it knocked my socks off. And I was actually, coming into that show, I wasn't in a great mood. And it was hard to not be in a great mood coming out of that. The sound, it's really difficult to explain. But the sound that came out of those speakers at certain points was something like I had never heard before. Especially when they're all in harmony belting.
Then we saw weekend one, Blackpink.
All I can say was production value was the highest it can be. I think that with Drone Show, they did this drone show. And then of course, it was just banger after banger.
Calvin Harris, so we didn't see Calvin last night, weekend two, but we saw him weekend one and it was fucking awesome. Two, one, let's go. Had a blast. Played all the bangers, played all the hits, really got us all in the nostalgic vibes. I think the whole crowd just kind of got in touch with their younger self and, you know, heard all of the songs that used to bring us so much joy and still do. It was everything. John was bawling during Calvin Harris.
Yeah, so the state of Kate, but right now it's gonna be the state of John. One of my favorite moments of all time at Coachella was the last time Calvin Harris played. It was the sunset set, the climax of the set, and just seeing the entire field moving like a sieve with just like jumping and just like breathing. It was crazy. And so I never thought I'd really be able to see that again.
Yeah.
And so like seeing him coming in this year was really exciting. That I was like, I get to maybe do this again. But he knew exactly his audience and he nailed it. And so I had a moment. I bawled my eyes out at some point. Super funny. Our friend who they went last night and we weren't there, I checked in with him. I said, how was it? Like, how did you enjoy it? And he said, like, you know, honestly, I cried. I was like, dude, me too. Like, so I think that we're just getting older, a little nostalgic, but yeah. It was really special to have that moment again.
Gotta love some EDM tears. So that's Saturday, and we'll see you tomorrow for our Sunday recap. Happy Coachella.
It's the last day of Coachella, so what are we doing here, John?
Ribeyes, baby, ribeyes.
Ribeyes.
Strong, solid base, protein, and lots of fat.
Mm-hmm. Over here, we got our quesadilla station. Cheese is essential.
Fit check for the last day, even though I haven't done any of these yet throughout the entire festival. This is a little set from this company called Dish, spelled D-I-S-S-H. And for me, going to Coachella is all about loose, comfortable, flowy, baggy clothing that's really lightweight because I have POTS, postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome, which means I pass out in the heat. So I need things that are gonna be nice and flowy and not restricting my body. And bonus points, a lot easier to dance in.
Well, we are gonna be front row for Christine McQueen's, and I'm very happy about it.
Woo!
Mid-chella.
Knee tape tuna.
Tire change.
Mm-hmm, tire change.
Wheel change? I don't know. What do they do in NASCAR?
Sports.
Recap.
Woo!
We're tired in the best way possible.
Yes.
I guess we should start with weekend one because really nothing happened on Sunday of weekend one. Sadly, John had to fly to a funeral on that day, so we just had a girls' day here at the house. And then I went in with my friends around like 6:30 and we were able to catch Bjork, which was beautiful. She had a full orchestra and this gorgeous outfit. Her voice has not aged a day.
And we kicked it off with Christine and the Queens, or Chris and the Queens. Which was an amazing set. We're huge Christine and the Queens fans. We've seen him before, and it was one of the best shows we've ever seen. Amazing production, super fun, beautiful, heartfelt. We knew that he had put out a more recent album, or is launching one soon, and so we didn't know fully what to expect. We knew it was gonna be different. It was very different, a total different direction. No dancers, very introspective, I would say. But it also had a really heavy rock theme to it, and it was beautiful, and it was just so much emotion coming out. You know, I think that in terms of publicity or popular culture, this album probably won't sell as well or won't let transcend different, you know, audiences as much, but it's clear that he doesn't really care and that this is about his journey, and the crowd was there for it.
Then we caught a couple songs of Bjork, which was beautiful, same thing as weekend one, just, you know, a really ethereal, beautiful moment. Then what I think for me was the highlight of the whole day was Blink-182 at main stage. They fucking crushed it. And man, I really had a moment during Blink-182. I just started crying during What's My Age Again, because I just felt like for one brief moment in time, I was a kid again.
Man, Weekend 2 main stage, they just brought it. And it seems like they haven't aged a day. It seems like they've been touring the whole time. It was just absolutely perfect. They each did it individually, they each did a perfect job. I mean, Travis was amazing on the drums.
And then, like 5 minutes after Blink ended, PHM went on. Fred Again Fortet and Skrillex. And John loves them in particular, so you want to talk about it?
I was really excited for this. And so for me, I knew this was going to be really, really special. I'm not necessarily like, this isn't my favorite electronic artist, but it was just clear that this was going to be a thing. One of the surprises was, or maybe not a surprise, but I don't think anybody anticipated what it would look like, is that they played at the end of the catwalk. So they were in the center of the field and they had lights, you know, shooting straight up into the air. I've never seen a dance party like that happen on the field.
It was the craziest I have ever seen Coachella. It was the perfect way to close out the weekend. I think Blink-182 was the headliner of Sunday, and then Skrillex, Fortet, and Fred Again was the after party. That's the vibe that it gave me, and I thought it was just perfect in every single way. Cheers to Sunday / day 6. We did it. Goodbye, Coachella.
You want to say goodbye to Coachella?
Bye, Coachella.
Bye to Coachella vlog. Bye, Coachella vlog.
See ya.
Caitlin, you did it! 20,000 subscribers! Oh, I'm so proud of you! You're so amazing! You're so amazing! I got some gifts for you, too!
Oh my god! Oh my god! Flowers! Love it! Beautiful. What? Yeah. Card. Sexy influencer. And there's a balloon over there that says congratulations. That's really, oh, it's Baby Yoda! I love Baby Yoda. This is the way to celebrate. Aw, congratulations, Caitlin. It feels like yesterday when you took a leap of faith and rigged up your iPhone in our Echo Park apartment and pressed the record button. I'm so proud of what you've accomplished. 20,000 subscribers, wow. But I know it hasn't been easy. You have grinded harder than anyone I know and have pushed past the trolls and negativity. It's amazing to see you grow as a person alongside your channel. I can't wait to celebrate the next milestone with you. All my love, John. Aw, and you got Michelle to do it too. Congratulations, Kate. You should be very proud of this huge accomplishment. It's so great to see success come to those that stick to their craft and follow their passion. I'm so happy for you and can't wait for your next milestone. Keep at it, girl. The world needs more authentic people like you. Love, Elle. Aw, that's so cute. Thank you.